In today's class, let us learn about volcanoes and its types. Volcanoes. A volcano is a vent or an opening on the surface of the earth crust through which hot, solid, liquid and gaseous materials erupt out to the surface from the earth's interior. Magma rises up and ejects on the surface as lava. Volcanoes also form when plates move apart. The term volcano is derived from the Latin term vulcan, which is the name of Roman god of fire. And this is the magma chamber from where the magma comes out to the surface of the earth as lava. And this magma is extremely hot liquid and semi-liquid rock located under the earth's surface. This magma can push through the holes or cracks in the earth's crust, causing a volcanic eruption. When magma flows or erupts on Earth's surface, it is called lava. Like solid rock, magma is a mixture of materials. Volcanoes have the following major components. Magma chamber, a large pool of liquid rock found beneath the surface of the Earth. Vent. Vent is an opening serving as an outlet for air, smoke, fumes, magma, etc. Volcanic cone, a landform built by the magma ejected from the vent in the shape of a cone. So during the first volcanic eruption, we cannot see the volcanic cone. But after the subsequent eruptions, the piling up of the lava causes this volcanic cone to form. Crater. The crater is the bowl-shaped opening located at the top of the volcano. The crater is located at the top. The side vent is active and a lava flow is running down the side of the cone. A fissure that brings the magma to the side vent. The fissure brings the magma to the side vent. Based on the periodicity of eruptions, volcanoes are classified into active volcano, dormant volcano and extinct volcano. What is an active volcano? Active volcanoes are those which constantly eject volcanic lava, gases and fragmented materials. Otherwise, we can call them as living volcanoes also. And examples of active volcanoes are Mount Stromboli in Italy. And this Mount Stromboli, it is in Mediterranean Sea, which is also called as Lighthouse of the Mediterranean Sea because of its frequent eruption. And it is the longest continuous ever erupting volcano for more than 2000 years. Mount St. Helens in USA. It lastly erupted in the year 1980. Mount Vesuvius on the west coast of Italy is the only active volcano on mainland Europe. It is best known because of the eruption in 79 AD that destroyed the cities of Pompeii and Herculaneum. The whole city was buried by the volcanic ash. Dormant volcano, which is also called a sleeping volcano. It is an volcano, active volcano, that is not erupting but is supposed to erupt again at any time. On Fujiyama in Japan, Kilimanjaro, Mauna Kea in Hawaii are the examples of dormant volcano. And here is an interesting fact about Mount Kilimanjaro. Kilimanjaro has three volcanic cones, Mavanzi, Shira and Kibo. Mavanzi and Shira are extinct, but Kibo, the highest peak, is dormant and could erupt at any time. The most recent activity was about 200 years ago. The last major eruption was 36,000 years ago. Extinct volcanoes. An extinct volcano has not had an eruption for at least 10,000 years and is not expected to erupt again in a comparable time scale of the future. Even the Tiruvannamalai mountain in Tamil Nadu, India is an example of extinct volcano. And this is the Nevado de Toluca near Mexico City. You can see the crater filled up with water. Now let us see the types of volcanoes classified based on their structure and composition. Composite volcano. Composite volcano, which is also known as strata volcano, is a conical volcano built by many layers, hardened layers, lava pumice and volcanic ash. Here you can see is visible here. The layers, the hardened layers of the magma or lava are visible here. And these are commonly found in Pacific Ocean. Example, Mount Fujiyama of Japan. Volcanic dome or lava domes. A lava dome or volcanic dome is roughly a circular mound formed due to the slow ejection of viscous lava. What is viscosity? It is the thickness of lava is called as viscosity. As the lava is rich in silica with intense viscosity, it is prevented from flowing, for it just oozes out very lazily from its vent. Example, Paricutín of Mexico. This is the picture of Paricutín of Mexico. Actually, these lava domes are formed a viscous magma being erected effusively onto the surface and then piling up around the vent. Like lava flows, they typically do not have enough gas or pressure to erupt explosively, although they may sometimes be preceded or followed by explosive activity. The next one is shield volcano. Shield volcanoes are formed by intense viscous lava. These are shallow depositions with gently sloping sides. Hence, the lava flows out in all directions to create a shield-like structure. Example is Mauna Lava of Hawaii. Now, let us see about the distribution of earthquakes and volcanoes. Most earthquakes and volcanoes do not strike randomly but occur along the plate boundaries. One such area, what is this plate boundary actually? The place where the tectonic plates meet is called as plate boundaries. One such area is the Circum-Pacific Ring of Fire, where the Pacific plate meets many surrounding plates. The Ring of Fire is the most seismically and volcanically active zone in the world. The other distinctive major belts are mid-oceanic ridges, mid-continental belts, and alpine Himalayan belt. Here we can see the mid-Atlantic Ocean ridge is the longest mountain chain of the world. And these mid-ocean ridges, the longest chain of mountains of the world, they are formed because of the divergent plate boundaries, because of the action of divergent plate boundaries. That is, when the plate boundaries move apart from each other, these ridges were formed. And this picture shows the Circum-Pacific Ring of Fire, this red dotted area. Here the crust of the earth is very, very weak, and 90% of the active volcanoes of the world are found along the Circum-Pacific Ring of Fire. What are the constructive effects of volcanoes? Volcanic materials enrich the soil fertility that promotes agricultural activities. The hot volcanic region helps in generating geothermal energy. Geo means earth. So the heat or energy that is generated from beneath the surface of the earth is called as geothermal energy. And it is a renewable resource of energy. So this is this. Good for increasing our renewable energy source and use. Many dormant and active volcanoes are the most attractive tourist spots of the world. Most of the volcanic materials are used as building materials. Destructive effects of volcanoes. Volcanic eruption causes earthquakes, flash floods, mudslide, and rockfall. Lava can travel very far and burn, body, or damage anything in its path, as it did in Pompeii, Vesuvius. The large amount of dust and ash makes breathing hard and irritable. Volcanic eruptions can alter the weather conditions and disrupt transport in and around the volcanic region. And the example is Iceland volcanic eruption. The smoke from the Iceland volcanic eruption around 10 or 12 years back, it disturbed the whole air traffic of the European countries. And with this, we come to the end of this lesson. Hope you all understood this lesson